you like our videos, please like and subscribe. That way this chonky boy can eat more this month. Isn't that right, buddy? God, you even know where the camera is. You're such a little... Alrighty. Welcome, ladies and gentlemen, to the channel for the first time. If you are new, and if you do enjoy, please like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. It does help us out and show us that you support and want to see more. And if you are currently subscribed and following and supporting the channel, then welcome back to the back, and we very much appreciate your continued support, myself included. Now, today, we are doing something a little special. With the release of Mortal Kombat 1 on the horizon and the beta testing coming up this weekend, I thought it best to do a little bit of a celebratory Mortal Kombat watch along. I polled the channel to determine which one to do, and y'all, in a fucking landslide, 70% of y'all said to do the original, the 95 Mortal Kombat film, the classic original film with Robin Cho and Kerry Hiroyuki Tagawa and Christopher Lambert and all the other very, very incredible, wonderful, talented members of the cast that that worked on and put this glorious, glorious movie together. So, we are going to sit down and we're going to do a little reaction and review of the film. And yeah, I'm just gonna sit through here, enjoy a nostalgia trip, and basically just have my Mortal Kombat mood primed and ready for when beta releases, and I'm gonna be playing a lot of it. So with that in mind, we'll be playing a lot of Baldur's Gate in the coming days, on probably Tuesday and Thursday of this week. This will probably be up on Tuesday morning, I would think. So if you're watching this on Tuesday, can tune in to my Baldur's Gate stream, as it will probably be on during the time that this goes up, or sometime afterwards. So you can look forward to that. Now, I had also planned to... Unfortunately, I didn't get the weekend off for that Mortal Kombat gameplay, but I did plan to do as much streaming of the gameplay as possible, because I want to get good. I want to get good with Scorpion and Kenshi. I think Scorpion's one of the playable characters in the... Or actually, no. I don't think he is one of the playable characters in the DLC. Or not DLC, the beta. I think it's just Kenshi, Liu Kang, Katana, Johnny Cage, and there's one that I'm slipping my mind of. I don't think that it's Scorpion, unfortunately. Actually, is it? Is it Scorpion? Let me double check real quick. It's the MK1 beta characters, and that will include Liu Kang, Sub-Zero, Kenshi, Johnny Cage, Li Mei, and Katana. That's who it was. That's who it was. Okay. Right. So, unfortunately, I won't get to play my main man, but I'll get to play my second bestie, Kenshi. I'm very, very excited for that. So, tune in this weekend for that as well. But, without further ado, we'll dive right into this. It's been... Actually, for myself, it's probably been a good... It's been probably around at least... 6 or more years since I've actually watched this movie. Like, I've seen clips from it, I've seen Sonic HxD's video on it, I've seen other people's videos on it, so I'm familiar with it, like, just from nostalgia and everything and seeing all that, but I haven't actually sat down and watched it in forever. So I'm very curious to see how it actually like holds up as a film in itself, not just as like my rose-tinted glasses kind of thing. So let's find out, shall we? Without further ado, 3, 2, 1, let us begin. I forgot it fucking opened like that. Yes! Yes! Fucking goddammit, dude. Yes, would be Kun Lao. And the man himself, yeah. He did so much for Shang Tsung, man. Yes, we'll be seeing that shot a few times in the film. Oh, on this one too.
Your brother.
Dude, Shang, brother, dead return. Dude, I forgot how fucking... I forgot how straight to the point that shit was.
B, I want Kano.
Trust me, Sonya.
I trust one person on this planet, Jax. You're talking to her.
Dude. Dude, that's such a disrespect to Jax. This is very terrible. Holy shit. Oh, god damn. Especially in the second film. Well, actually, let's not even talk about the second film. Just in every other media with Jax and Sonya's relationship. Great.
Right on time.
Great performance of Kano here as well. Very
I
much
in punctuality in a woman.
Very much influenced the character going
Gun
forward.
Mr. Shang Tsung.
That accent has stayed like synonymous with Kano.
Now you sure she's gonna follow me?
I remember this fucking MacDoc. Jesus. Jesus fucking. Oh my god, that's hilarious. He's actually not bad either. Like, he's actually got the moves. Oh, yes, this!
I don't know how to do this stuff.
This all shit, I remember what this was.
No, what do you mean you're not doing it?
I mean, I'm not doing it.
The stand-in for Steven Spielberg, who was supposed to be in this.
I'm gonna get a gun, then I'm gonna shoot myself for being in your movie!
Kill me, kill me, I'll be back directing traffic! Johnny, don't leave me hanging up here!
You're killing me, Johnny!
Oh my god, that's brutal.
Johnny!
Set, you don't know who it is?
No, of course not.
It better not be a reporter.
Oh god, no, I will. You want me to find out?
A little late for that, buddy. Prepare to be fired.
Best fighters in the world are invited. You win the tournament, you win their respect. They'll tell the entire world that you're the real goods.
So,
and Johnny Cage is like, yeah, sure, I want fame. Let's go kick some ass.
Hong Kong.
But then you have stuff like this where they actually go to, like, real world sets and shit. And you get absolutely gorgeous shots like that. Like, amazing.
Kang has been given the dream. He is the chosen one.
No, she left our temple. Turn his back on us.
I like how this dissenters
Why
are like,
have you come
fuck
back?
Him.
Yes, I forgot. We're fighting for the fate of the world.
That's why you left the temple and ran away.
The best parts of the movie, god damn it. Yes, Christopher Lambert, yes.
But vengeance. That's so much simpler.
Fucking reveal.
Lord Raiden.
God damn it.
You're still running away from your destiny.
Absolutely love that.
He's just a beggar.
Spare him, my Lord Raiden. American life has enfeebled his mind. Too much television.
Oh,
so you're
Jesus
going to win
Christ
the tournament.
Yes,
right,
I am.
I remember that line now.
Show me how.
Get fucked. I give you one flip. fucking lightning effects, goddammit.
If you are Raiden.
If you are Raiden.
Why did you let Chang?
Has fucking sparks his eyes.
Why didn't you protect
if
him?
You are Raiden.
Why didn't you?
I've had enough of this.
I will say it is not badly written. Some of the dialogue's goofy, but that's again product of its time. I like they have a respect for each other, and like the Art Lean can tell he's an actual fighter.
When the ship comes in, could you put these on board?
You want me to carry your luggage?
Oh right.
Yeah. I pay money, you carry the bags.
Oh, I forgot he was a fucking racist asshole. That serves him right.
Thank God I didn't ask him to park the car.
Oh, Jesus Christ. That is a cool ship. That is a really cool fucking... I'm pretty sure that was an actual prop, too, that they used. Like, that is a really fucking cool ship.
Come to Papa.
Ew. Yeah, they all have this weird... like, thing for Sonya. It's just...
Don't get on that thing! Hey, Sonya!
It's another Starstruck fan, huh?
I love, absolutely love Robin Joe's, Joe's facial expressions. So good. Ah, yes.
Got that radio handy?
So this was, somewhat of a controversial choice.
Sub-Zero. Deadliest of enemies. Put slaves under my power.
Yeah.
Move aside.
So they just right away their conflict by saying, ah, they're under Shanks' mind control. Oh god, that spear. That fucking living spear, Jesus Christ.
Of course. Until we reach the island where you have no dominion.
My dominions are well known to me, sorcerer. Thank you.
What tournament?
Thank you. Love that.
You've been chosen, Sonya.
Coming out of his hand, we got another guy who freezes stuff. And then there's a man who, as far as I can tell, is made out of electricity. I mean, how did he disappear like that? What is going on here? Who is this guy?
Let's just think this through. There is a rational explanation for this.
I love Lyndon Ashby's
God of lightning and protector
reactions.
Of the realm of Earth.
A handful of people on a leaky boat are gonna save the world.
Exactly.
Exactly.
The essence of mortal combat.
Oh, I love that.
One of you three will decide the outcome of the tournament. The fate of billions will depend upon you.
That's fucking Raiden laugh. Oh, I love his, like, goofy, like... It's just like playful enjoyment of the situation.
Only with vengeance. If you challenge Shang Tsung now,
like until shits get serious.
You will lose your life.
It has begun.
Yeah. God. I fucking love this. I mean, fucking love this movie.
Jax, this is Sonya. Do you copy?
While you're at it, why don't you call my agent?
Do I look like your secretary?
They've got some great fucking banter in this new, I'll admit, compared to some other versions of these characters, they got some really good banter. Whee!
Where the hell are you?
No more helpful.
Do I look like your travel agent?
Okay.
Yeah.
I give up.
Yeah, that's fucking hilarious, dude.
What's going on?
I don't know.
You saved that one for the show.
But what if all the legends...
What legends?
Dude, for fuck's sakes. Kano was the Johnny... Like, or... Yeah, Kano was the Johnny Cage in Mortal Kombat 2021. Like... the humor that Johnny puts out in this one is very, very much the same kind of use that he. Oh god, that green screen. Oh god. Yikes. Oh god, this fucking thing. Oh. Oh yes, and Kitana.
Princess Kitana. She's our most dangerous adversary. Watch her carefully, reptile. Keep her away from these humans.
Yeah, there it is, yeah. Yeah, that fucking thing. Oh, God. Oh, yeah, this is fucking hilarious. They all sit down, get ready to eat, and then they start the shit.
Some of you will even have the distinct honor and pleasure to face Prince Goro.
Goro, yeah, boys.
Our reigning champion. You were all witnesses to one of the greatest turning points in the history of your planet.
He's hit and miss in this one. But a technical marvel of his time. Well, there's one guy in the background that kind of looks like Cobra. I'm not sure if that was intentional or not, but he kind of had, like, the long blonde hair, the black, like, fingerless gloves. He didn't have the white gi on, but... Clear! 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 This is so fucking dumb. This is equivalent to, like, the Indiana Jones, like, sword twirling versus gun. What I want to know is if this guy actually thought he had a chance against Sub-Zero, or if he knew he was a sacrifice just for this show.
Flawless victory.
And just so Shang Tsung could say flawless victory.
You know, you gotta admire her. When she sets her mind on something.
Jesus Christ.
It's not her mind you're admiring.
Yeah, oh, dude. Both of those fucking banger lines. Oh, and our first look at Goro, yes. Look at those meaty fingers. Didn't fucking notice them. He just round the corner then and did fucking notice them coming up.
How many times do I have to tell you?
Unless he was leading them there, which I think he was, but still.
We can't help it. It's a guy thing.
You'd think that he would.
Hey, where are you going?
It's a guy thing. Him. Jesus Christ.
I work.
Find out what that was. Lou and I will wait right here. What?
I absolutely fucking love him in this.
Almost lost my lunch.
There he
Disgusting.
Is. Absolutely love Goro.
If this Shang Tsung guy is so great, how come he's got such a crummy looking boat? Hmm?
Nah. Shang Tsung is a great sorcerer.
Why you don't shit talk him against his biggest simp.
Those who challenge his power become his slaves.
Yeah? You're some kind of royalty too. Right.
I am Goro, General of the Armies of Outworld and Prince of the Subterranean Realm of Shokan.
Subterranean?
Oh, just...
What's that? Something like underground?
Yes.
I like how he still runs his mouth even against this giant fucking forearm man.
Back home.
How lucky for them. Back home.
He does move a little
true.
Strange
Prince
now and again. He moves a little jittery, but
why
for the most part,
would I have chosen
really fucking well made.
Yet in the realm of Earth, men like him can amass great wealth and almost godlike power.
It's not wrong.
Yeah. And I'd like to get back to my amassing as soon as possible, if you don't mind.
Princess Kitana.
The Emperor's adopted daughter? Why should I worry about her?
Princess Kitana.
I like how this whole scene is just a fucking lore dump.
She must not be allowed to join.
But it's framed in a conversation rather than just one guy dumping us.
So special about you.
What is it?
We are not
alone.
Which means he didn't lead them down there. So the three of them are hanging back, like, not even 10 feet. And he didn't notice them. He looked over his fucking shoulder and he didn't notice them.
Look.
What? Oh god, that CG reptile is so fucking goofy, man. Oh my god. One of the worst reptile designs, too. I'm gonna be real.
Lou, what happened? There's something here. I think it's following Princess Katana.
I can smell a perfume.
I don't smell anything.
And wait for it.
I smell something. Bullshit.
I fucking love that. Oh my god, that dude, the writing between the three of these guys is just fucking golden in this movie. I like how there's three for Johnny, two for fucking Lou, and one for Sonya. Like, why the aggression against Johnny rather than Lou? Random ass fucking flipping there for no reason. I also like how all of these, like, temple guards are wearing, like, motocross armor for chest pads. Almost.
Brilliant. Absolutely brilliant.
Absolutely brilliant. Absolutely fucking love this, man.
Why don't you show me what you plan to do? I don't think so.
The fucking rated laugh is so good, man. I absolutely love that fucking laugh. Oh my goodness.
You guys are lucky you stopped us.
God damn it.
So now you've seen what you'll
Lyndon Ashby in the role of Johnny is really good. And Shanks. I'm not sure how Carl Urban will do as Johnny Cage, but he can do funny pretty well. But I don't know how he'll be as Johnny Cage, but I believe in him. Carl Urban's fucking awesome.
Let Mortal Kombat begin.
This was a pretty cool fight, I remember. This is a pretty neat fight. I don't remember the specifics of it, but it was pretty cool. Little fucking jump, goddammit. I'm liking the staff combat. It's been a while since I've seen this, but it's really nice to watch. Okay, that's pretty fucking cool. The quarter staff roll into the fucking kick. That's pretty sick. I also love the little fucking lion roar that they give this guy every time he did the ah.
Your soul is mine.
Yes, it is.
No.
The way.
Fatality.
Fatality, goddamn. But Liu Kang didn't kill him, so why are you calling fatality?
Sonya Blade.
I like how they don't give any build up to it at all either. They just throw Sonya right at Kino. No holds barred. There's
the
just like.
I have something you want.
Right in. Much. Let's just give him Kino right off the bat.
Hello, baby. Did you miss me?
Though I do like the performance here. I really, really do like this performance. As it has influenced a lot of his iterations since then. And still does.
Little baby brings back memories.
I do like how they replicate his butterfly knife from the game, though. That's pretty cool.
Nah.
I like that transition. That's
baby.
Such a.
I've studied all your moves.
Yeah, study this.
That's a real nice. attempt at cheating there, which is very Kano. Oh yeah, and then this is over real fast. I like how she, I was just looking like thighs, yes.
Oh, give me a break.
Okay.
Crack. Rip. Yay for vengeance. I like how they don't fucking have any space between some of these fights, so they just go rapid fire too.
Get over here!
But there's a classic voice.
Get over here.
Yeah, this was some bullshit though. The spear being just like its own sentient thing that's a fucking homing beacon is like something. This makes no sense. I think how he somehow sneaks up on him out of this. Yeah, where the fuck did he come from? Okay, this I remember being a change that the audience has wanted. Because the Johnny Scorpion fight was supposed to end right about there. And then they introduced the Scorpion's lair, Netherrealm-ish looking place. Which was an actual set, and this was fucking cool. Seeing the behind the scenes for this was really fucking cool. This was a cool shot.
Welcome.
That welcome line is so good too. The choreography in this is really fucking cool too. Like, the fights were really well done in this, for the most part. I love how they gave Scorpion all this fucking love and treatment too. Like, dude, he has one of the longest fights in the movie. That was pretty good.
Get down here!
I like how they gave a Scorpion a bunch of lines in this film too. Like, unlike some where it's just like, get over here and that's it. Or appearances of him, rather. I mean, you have this. Honestly, that's not a... I'm gonna be real, that's not even that bad of an effect. It looks like it's a combination of, like, a mask and CG. Oh, yeah, like, it's really... It still looks really good. Oh, you know what, actually? It might even just be, like, an animatronic mask. When I was a kid, I thought that this was actually on Scorpion. Like, Scorpion had that for some reason. I was just like, why the fuck does he have that photo? Now I realize that's a reference to Johnny Cage's, like, you know, winning taunt thing. Actually, no, I think it's his opener. He, like, tosses a signed photograph off into the crowd. I also like how their stances kind of mirror how they pose in the game and stuff.
With all of your heart, there is no hope. To win your next match, use the element which brings life.
What?
What? Remember my words.
The element which brings life. This is so goofy.
You disappoint me.
I also like how this fight went on for like
not very wise.
40 seconds, and Shang Tsung's like, enough. You got the you're losing. You suck. Get the fuck out of here. I want to see your ass beat even further. Your disappointment. Man, they're about to do Sub-Zero dirty, and I can't wait. He's getting his ass kicked, so he fucking pushes candles in his face. Goddamn. But I guess that's something that actually they did carry into further Mortal Kombat, is like the stage interactions. So that's actually not out of the ordinary for Mortal Kombat. It's fucking. God, what the fuck is that, man? This is so silly.
Water.
Potter, yes, of course. I actually need to kill him with water. I like how Sub-Zero made this move where he's gotta like focus, he's gotta concentrate on it, right? He's gotta make this giant ball of ice. And he sees the fucking buckets of water there, he's like, nah, he's not gonna pick it up and throw it at me and, you know, freeze the ice into a weapon that can instantly kill me in one shot. Nah, he wouldn't do that. He's just gonna leave the buckets of water and try to, you know, fight me head on like a honorable opponent, right?
Is it time?
Right? This is a fun way of showing Goro's power and everything without having to bring out the animatronic and do all these fights. I like how they're all on like stones and this one's in an actual boxing arena for some reason. Dude, Goro's theme is so fucking hype too, goddamn. Poor Arlene's about to get his ass kicked.
What the?
Also, like how he says, what the, as if he hasn't heard or seen Goro beat everyone else's ass. He smacks him once, then he gives fucking, just fucking taunts. Yes, Goro. God, those fucking eyes. I forgot about that look they give. Like, get out! Get out, he says, and he's just getting fucking pummeled.
Time to die.
Finish him!
Smack. One fucking crack to his chest, that's all it takes. Which, I mean, from Goro, yeah, I can see. Why are you screaming? Johnny had more interaction with him than you ever did. Why are you the one screaming and being like, why? No. What the fuck? That's a pretty good shot. Okay, there's Johnny screaming. That makes sense. That adds up. Why the fuck was Sonya screaming first?
If you are to conquer them, you, Johnny, are afraid you're fake. So you'll rush into any fight just to prove you're not.
I feel like that they tried to replicate this in the 2021 scene.
Bravely enough.
In the cave.
Foolishly. Carelessly. And you'll be beaten.
Where Raiden just rips apart each fucking character one by one. Yeah.
Wait.
Where's my fortune cookie?
Wait. What about me?
It's literally the same thing. Oh my god, it's the same fucking thing.
You already fled once when you went to America.
It's the same fucking thing.
It has brought you guilt for the death of your brother.
You suck. You can amount to nothing. You fear that you're nothing. You absolutely fucking you suck. You've got trust issues. Do better.
It's the most dangerous fear of all.
You also don't have a tattoo, so you're not as powerful.
So does Shang Tsung.
Hey, Gandalf, wish my fortune.
Your soul and use the fear he sees there against you.
God fucking damn it, man.
You must be prepared.
Oh, here we go again. You will be next.
You're making this all sound really simple, and it isn't.
Yeah, it is.
Okay, this is a bit
because
cringe.
I can't let what happened to Art happen to you.
Yeah, this is cringe. Oh
not
my god.
Not to you.
Not to you.
Oh, don't you
what?
Dare do this to protect
what
me,
Johnny. What the fuck does that mean?
Trust me. I got a plan.
Oh, I can't believe this. You are the most evil.
That eager to die. I'm not the one who's gonna die.
No. I like the fucking. The absolute.
Very foolish.
Disbelief and smirk on
you want to protect your friends
on his fucking face just like
no mistake.
I have no words for how funny that is. Well,
in return I reserve the right to challenge the winner myself or another of my choosing.
Yep, that clause.
Place designated by me for the final battle of the tournament.
And then Johnny, being a dumbass, agrees
you
to it.
You got it, pal.
I don't think so.
Mortal Kombat. We fight it.
Good. At last, one of them is understood.
I love that fucking performance of Mr. Lambert. So fucking good. So why was every other fight out here, but the arcane fight inside in the boxing ring? At that point, it would have made sense to do the Arlene fight first and then the montage after. Yeah, nice callback. Very good. Oh, this fucking. Yes.
I'll crush him in one blow.
The 80 honors mouse was a little off there. And. Nut Punch reference. Very nice. Very good. Yeah.
Sorry.
God, I. God, I love his fucking mischievous Raiden. He's so fucking funny. Oh god, that green screen. Oh lord. Yeah, it's pretty bad.
Those were $500 sunglasses, asshole.
God damn it. I can't tell you how many times I quoted that shit as a kid.
This is where you fall down.
Yeah, this fucking callback line, goddammit. And then an absolutely abysmal green screen. Stop! And Bridget Wilson screaming is like,
I hereby exercise
my shit is shrill. Shit.
I'm sorry.
You're sorry.
There is one last rule. He neglected to mention it.
Oh.
She has to accept the challenge, or there can be no final combat.
Yes.
I have nothing further to teach you, Liu Kang.
I forgot about that.
You possess the
And
knowledge.
What the fuck do you mean? All I have another nothing further to will. Teach you.
You sure you don't want to go with us?
In Outworld,
oh my god, that fucking camouflage, Jesus Christ.
You will find.
I'm telling you, I hate it. I'm in a hostile environment, I am completely unprepared, I'm surrounded by people who probably want to kick my ass. It's like being back in high school. What's that?
It's just a bunch of random denizens of Outworld just fucking shuffling around.
What?
Grabbing the CGI ugly lizard man. I also never got this. Like, what the fuck was... Like, what was this? You're telling me these statues are sentient? Or something? That's pretty goofy, but... I do kind of like the reptile design. For a class of reptile, anyways. The reptile before his transformation, though, is pretty fucking silly. Dude, the soundtrack in this is just all fucking bangers. Like, they're just hype. And this is actually a pretty good combat, actually. Now I'm watching it again. The CGI reptile's just dumb. Oh, good fucking leg sweep. Oh, damn. That's fucking quick snap. Oh, yeah, the fucking reptile classic fucking position there. Absolutely love that. Oh yeah, the fucking bicycle kick, yeah. Nice. Oh yeah, I forgot the mask, the fucking lizard mask was like reminiscent of the statue that he was transformed in. He had a vendetta against that fucking reptile, goddamn.
Well done.
In the Black Tower, you will face three challenges. You must face your enemy, you must face yourself, and you must face your worst fear.
Oh my god, yeah, that fucking... Oh god, that green screen. Oh! Oh, good lord. That was especially bad. Holy shit.
The realm of Earth will forfeit the tournament.
Lol. And its portals but will open. Also, why the fuck did he that's just so creepy. Why the fuck would he change her off screen? They do that a lot in Mortal Kombat where they fucking change them off screen and chain them up like that. Against home.
Such an endearing human trait, I'm touched.
And betray our emperor? In his great wisdom, he knows that Mortal Kombat cannot be won by treachery.
How?
In his great wisdom?
Speak to me of treachery.
Really?
Your
really?
Will lose
Shao Kahn.
For all time, the keys to the.
He believe. Well, I mean, this is Kitana being naive, so. Yeah, Shao Kahn would do that shit.
I challenge you to Mortal Kombat. Do you accept or yield?
I accept.
Now clear my floor. Yeah, I was gonna say, get the fuck out of here.
I will take care of this impudent mortal myself.
Nice dress.
God damn it, Johnny. Oh, here comes the theme again, yep. Dude, Jerry Jagawa's pretty fucking good himself in terms of, combat. Oh, I just realized this outfit is a reference to his young, not old, like, outfit, where it's not black, but it's the yellow one with the long black ponytail. And like the face paint with the white eyes. I'm pretty sure that's kind of the like outfit they're trying to mimic there.
What's that sound?
We have a fucking wild variety of warriors here I fucking forgot about. Like the samurai and shit. that's pretty cool. That's pretty fucking cool. Like I snuck around Liu Kang and ran up the steps while he was looking.
Is that all you've got, sorcerer?
Liu Kang! I can see into your soul. You will die.
Absolutely love this man's performance, goddammit.
Face yourself.
You can look into my soul. But you don't own it.
Face your worst fear.
That was facing himself. Really? Destiny. That was it.
Face me.
What?
Raiden sent me to help you. You're not really Chan.
Yeah. That's such a fucking poor lie, too.
Remember when our parents died?
He hears the mechanism activating. It's like,
come with me.
Yeah. Yeah. Let's go. Let's do this.
Forgive you for letting me die. No.
And then the real decision.
It wasn't my fault. Chan chose his own path. Every man is responsible for his own destiny.
Ah, the realization's dawning on him.
Shang Tsung killed my brother.
Oh my.
I like how he saw him fucking shapeshift and he still fucking played through that whole dialogue tree. Alright, you have him. Just fucking punt his ass off the fucking cliff. Like, why would you leave him and turn your back on him? Kick him into the spikes, you moron.
I am the chosen one.
Two very good references there with the fireball and the, you know, the side punch there.
Flawless victory.
Okay, you also are misusing that. You're misusing that term, Liu Kang. That is a really cool effect, though, I will say. For its time, that is a really cool effect. What a goofy pair of shots.
Let's go home.
Yep. What a weird fucking soundtrack choice, though.
I've been waiting for you. What took you so long?
I guess you knew it would end this way.
Didn't have a clue.
I also like how fucking Sonya and fucking Johnny are just like
I've got to tell you
all in each other's arms now and everything. Great. Like a couple and everything. What a squandered setup, man. Oh, god damn it. Look at that shit.
Pathetic fools.
What an absolute fucking treat of a film. Directed by Paul Andersen. Well, I will say, it is still a very, very good film. It's still very good. It holds up pretty well. Some things, however, do not. Some things really do not hold up too well. Like a lot of the CGI, and effects. Some of them are. They are dated. They are pretty oof. Even for that time, they were looking pretty oof in some scenes. The green screens especially. Oh, god, man. That one scene of Sonya chained up there and just fucking... Oh, god, that was so ugly. Absolutely ugly. But, other than that, like... I'd say my nostalgia holds up pretty well. There were a lot of a lot of the interactions, especially earlier on, between like Liu Kang, Sonya, and Johnny were just so well written for the characters. Their banter and everything was really funny, and it's still very good. And as I said, holds up today. It's still pretty solid. Some of it is pretty cringe. Like that whole scene between Johnny and Sonya, like on the fucking rock staring out into the sea, like Jesus Christ, that was oof. That was rough. That was hard to listen to because it's like Jesus, man, what the fuck? This is awfully weird. It just did not work. It was not great. Reptile is probably one of the worst design choices for this film, for sure, is the fucking CGI, like, velociraptor fucking looking thing. Once they got into, humanoid looking reptile, that was fine, that was okay. They should have done that, and then had him, like, pull off his mask, kind of like Scorpion, and, like, be a lizard man. But I guess that would have been too much similarity and overlap to Scorpion there. But, I mean, he could have done other things, like, you attack him, you rip a part of his tunic or something, and then you see scales underneath, and you're like, what the hell is this? But you start you get more and more, you see more scales underneath, and then eventually, like, fucking, you know, rips off the front of the mask, and you just get a lizard face. Like, that would be cool. That would be pretty cool. But instead they did CGI lizard man, and it's no, it's doesn't really work for me. It doesn't really work for me. Goro, in a lot of instances, was pretty damn good. He still held up pretty well. I will say a lot of the facial sides of that little puppet rig thing for Goro. It had a few malfunctions there, and again, there were some times where the ADR didn't really match up to his mouth at all. Now, that being said, it's still good. It's still fun. Still fun to watch him fucking shamble around and swing his arms around and everything. Like it's not the worst. But I do see the faults and the age showing quite a bit in some of the areas. I will say this Goro is definitely still better than the 2021 Goro, who, while being CGI and looking more natural in his movements, was kind of CGI and lost to Cole Young in the first encounter that he ever showed up in. So I don't really place much stock in that Goro, honestly. this guy beat, like, what, 10 dudes? Not including Art Lean and... like, I don't know. It's just, I still prefer this Goro. Again, as I said, there are some things that are a little not done well. Like, some of the relationship bits, as I said, with Sonya and Johnny, Katani and Lou are a little weird and strained and a little forced, because that's how it is in the game, that they have a thing in the game, so it's gotta start building bridges for that. But they do it, like, so weirdly, it's just, ugh. I'll say for that lore dump dinner scene with Shang Tsung, Goro, and Kano. Normally you'd be like, ah, oh, this is exposition. But they framed it well. That was actually not a bad writing decision, to frame the exposition into a conversation, to naturally explain it to the audience, rather than just be like, oh yeah, you remember this? You remember that? You remember that? You remember that? It's still got a little bit of that, but it's an attempt to make it a little less, you know, just plot summary dump kind of thing, which I do appreciate as well. A lot of the fights in the film still held up pretty well. They're still pretty good. Lots of good choreography and action, like, pretty solid, pretty good. Love that. And there's a lot of good, you know, other scenes that just really elevated the overall experience, like the I'm like drawing a blank here because it's like almost one in the or it is one in the morning, so my brain is shutting off. Scenes okay, I'm just gonna cut this part because I don't know where I was going with that. I'll be honest, I kind of rambled off there for a second because my sleep deprivation's kicking in, but I did think that a lot of the scenes that they did do, when you had them dealing with the tournament and as a group, were well written and well handled. A lot of the stuff where they're off on their own, or in pairs rather, it started to falter a little bit, especially towards the later half of the movie. Not in like a bad way, just like it didn't have as much like cohesion, I suppose, as the like earlier sort of section of the film, because you had very good banter and dialogue between Sonya and Johnny and Liu Kang, and then you have Raiden come in there and you have their conversations, which were pretty good, but the conversations between Sonya and Johnny weren't good, the conversations Katana and Lou weren't good, or they felt really off, like, they just felt off overall. I mean, you had, like, the weird, like, every male character in this film, except for the fucking Art Lean and, I guess, Goro, was just, like, objectifying Sonya the whole time, and, like, giving her weird looks and, like saying weird shit. It's just, like, it was really a little off-putting, I suppose. But I guess that's also a product of its time as well, I would say. And you can't really... Oh, at the same time, it's bad. But I do understand that kind of some of that shit works its way into scripts from all kinds of things in that time, in that kind of era, and even still in the 90s. So it doesn't exactly surprise me, but it's still off-putting to see. Like, oh yeah, we're gonna change something into this leather, skimpy, really, really high-cut fucking skirt dress. Like, it'd be really weird. I mean, they did the like weird like poofy shit with her hair. Like, it just really Princess Leia-y, and like, ugh. And then Shang Tsung was expecting her to fight him in that, and it's like, the idea is like he wouldn't even think of that as like a competition. He'd probably turn it into something like, ugh. Like it's just the more you think about it, the more it doesn't sit well. But again, it seems to be a thing that Shao Kahn does a lot, where you like skipifies a lot of the women, but at the same time, it's I don't know. But regardless, the film overall holds up pretty well. It's still pretty fucking good. It's still pretty enjoyable. It's still pretty funny. It's definitely worth the watch, at least once or twice, you know, because it is a very good overall introduction to most aspects of Mortal Kombat. You have things like Scorpion and Sub-Zero that are just mind-controlled jobbers in this, which degrades their characters and kind of makes things, you know, it kind of belittles what your thought of that character is going into, like, the games or any other media, being like, why the fuck would they make a whole movie about Scorpion's revenge when he's a jobber, right? Kind of thing. It's a really weird primer for those characters, especially since they are so iconic and titular to the series. A really weird handling. And, as well as Reptile, the weird handling of him. There are a lot of positives, though, because a lot of the influences from this movie went on to like stay in the franchise for a very long time. A lot of the outfits, designs, plot lines, the whole basically the whole Kano persona and voice just got lifted from this from now on, because it was so well received that the developers were like, alright, well, Kano's Australian now. Kano's Australian, we're going with that. We're just fucking going with that shit. And then they just went with it from there. And there's still good things about the film, absolutely. But there are a lot of points because of its age. So just you do watch it, it's yourself, keep that in mind. But anyways, that being said, I think I'll stop rambling, because I'm going to either pass out or just fucking blank off and completely forget what I'm talking about again. So with that being said, I hope you enjoyed. To those of you that followed and subscribe and all that, and everything, and like, share, comment, all that, I very much appreciate it. It means a lot. And to those of you that are here for the first time and are maybe watching through this and enjoy it, then please, as I said, like, share, comment, subscribe, all that good stuff. And yeah, I'll see you all in the next video, and I will also see you all in the Baldur's Gate stream later this day, if you are watching this Tuesday of the 16th of August, and if not, then maybe you will also catch me playing Mortal Kombat 1 for the beta later this weekend, if you are watching this on the day as well. So, that being said, hope you all enjoyed, and I will see you all in the video. Adios.